if x and y are integers, 7 is less than y is less than 16, and x over y is equal to 2/5, how many possible values are there for x? So x and y have to be integers, and y is greater than 7 and less than 16. So let's, before we even think about this constraint right over here and this constraint, if we just had this constraint right over here, what are the possible values for y? Well, y is an integer greater than 7, so let's see, it would be 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and it can't be equal to 16, so we'll stop right over here. So just with that constraint, here are our candidate y's. Now they're saying x over y is equal to 2/5, or another, let me just rewrite that. So they're saying x over y is equal to 2/5, or if you multiply both sides by y, you get x is equal to 2 over 5y. Now, if x is equal to 2/5 y, so over here you would have 8 times 2/5. So let me write this down. So these are our possible y's, and then our possible x's, 8 times 2/5. Now, is this thing right over here going to be an integer? Remember, x and y need to be integers. Well, no, 8 isn't divisible by 5. 8 times 2 is 16. 16 isn't divisible by 5. And so this is not going to be an integer. Is 9 times 2/5, is that going to be an integer? No, 9 isn't divisible by 5. I think you start to see a pattern here. 10 times 2/5, is that going to be an integer? Sure, 10 is divisible by 5. 10 divided by 5 is 2. 10 divided by 5 is 2 times 2. This is equal to 4. So this is a possible value for x, and frankly, this is a possible value. This is a possible value for y, if we assume that they both have to be integers. And so we don't have to test all of these. We just say, look, which of these are also divisible by 5? Well, 10 is divisible by 5, and 15 is divisible by 5. None of these other ones are divisible by 5. So if y is 15, we don't even have to know what the value is, but we could say x is going to be 15 times 2/5, which is 15 divided by 5 is 3 times 2, which is 6. So there are two possible values. There are two possible values for x.